स्टरडे गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, क्लास नाइन्थ। द टॉपिक वॉट एवर वी हैव स्टार्टेड स्टरडे दैट इज मेकिंग ऑफ द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन अंडर विच वी हैव स्टडीड सम स्टेप्स एंड इन दिस सीक्वेंस नाउ टूडेज टॉपिक is the Constituent Assembly. An election had been held to the Constituent Assembly in July 1946. Its first meeting was held in December 1946. After partition of India and Pakistan, the Constituent Assembly was divided into Constituent Assemblies of India and Pakistan. That Constituent Assembly was divided into the Constituent Assemblies of India and Pakistan after the partition of India and Pakistan. The Constituent Assembly that wrote the Indian Constitution constituted 299 members. And whatever the Constituent Assembly that works in India and draft the Indian Constitution in that assembly there are 299 members. The assembly adopted the constitution on 26th November 1949. But the constitution came into effect on 26th January 1950. That's why we celebrate 26th January as the Republic Day in our country. Every year. Thereafter, legitimacy of the Indian Constitution today. The Constitution does not reflect the views of its members alone, but expresses a broad consensus of its time. Over the years, several groups have questioned some provisions of the Constitution. This is an unusual achievement for the Indian Constitution on the world stage. Another reason for accepting the Constitution is that the Constituent Assembly represented the people of India. The Constituent Assembly was elected by the members of the existing provincial legislatures. This ensured a fair geographical share of members from all regions of the country. After that, working of the Constituent Assembly. The Assembly was dominated by the Indian National Congress, which included a variety of political and regional groups of people. In social terms, the Assembly represented members from different language groups, caste, class, religion, and occupation. Finally, the Constituent Assembly worked in a systematic, open, and consensual, that means mutual consent manner, which gave sacred quality to the Constitution. After that, Drafting Committee and Constituent Assembly. First, some basic principles were decided and then a drafting committee under the chairmanship of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar prepared a draft constitution for discussion. One thing is there, the President of Constituent Assembly was Dr. Rajendra Prasad, who was the first president of India and belonged to a very backward village that is known as Jiradei in Siwan district in the state of Bihar. While the chairman of drafting committee was Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, who is also known as Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar, who prepared a draft constitution for discussion. The discussion of the draft constitution took place clause by clause. The members of the drafting committee completed the work in 114 days, spread over 3 years. More than 2,000 constitutional amendments were made. Every document presented and every word spoken in the Constituent Assembly has been recorded and preserved. These are called Constituent Assembly debates and have been printed in 12 bulky volumes. These debates provide a rationale behind every provision of the Constitution and are used to interpret the meaning of the Constitution. Now I am going to describe the important members who involved in drafting the Indian Constitution. In them, Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar was the chairman of drafting committee. After that, Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel, Abdul Kalam Azad, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, H.C. Mukherjee, now just I am telling you that Dr. Rajendra Prasad was the chairman of Constituent Assembly, while H.C. Mukherjee was the vice chairman of Constituent Assembly. Thereafter, G. Durgabhai Deshmukh, Baldev Singh, Dr. Bhimrao Ramaji Ambedkar, Shyama Prasad Mukherjee, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Sarojini Naidu. These are the important members who were contributed in drafting the Indian Constitution. Enough for today. Tomorrow again we will keep tomorrow will be our topic, guiding values of the Indian Constitution. Thank you.